developers. We're entering in the home stretch of our tech talks. And up next, I know I'm super excited to hear about serverless and sustainability in one. So we'll hear about how switching to serverless saves on costs and can save the planet. Please welcome to the stage respected leaders of the customer-to-customer, or C2C, community in France, Guillaume Blaquier, data architect for Carrefour, and Antoine Castex, data architect at L'Oréal.
Thank you for joining. The target of the presentation of today is to explain you how is it very interesting for you in terms of architecture choice that you will make to save first your money and also the planet. So my name is Antoine, I am working for L'Oréal.
I'm Guillaume Lacquier, I'm working for Carrefour.
I will not do any introduction about L'Oréal because I'm pretty sure already everybody knows very well L'Oréal. So first number one cosmetic luxury group in the world, present in more than 50 countries with 19,000 employees.
And Carrefour is one of the major retailers in France and in Europe, and our company are concerned about sustainability and to save the planet. Carrefour, for example, take care of the plastic in the store and take care also in the cloud to how you consume our services. Antoine and I are friends. We are leading the C2C France community. We are a group data architects in a large group, and we have a data lake, data warehouse, and we have similar problems. Can you tell us more about this problem?
So the problem seems to be very simple to solve, but we will see that there is different way to solve that problem. Imagine you are like me and Guillaume, you have some data, you have choose a dedicated cloud provider, which I hope it's Google Cloud. Huh? You put data, and more data. At the end, the target is to have more and more data, but you really want to know what the data you have in terms of how many lines of row, where the data is located, because it can be sometimes in some place and sometimes in another place because of some reason, security or legal restriction. But you need some data about this data. I call that metrics. Usually it's more metadata, but I would say it's data about data, okay? So the story we have to tell you today is we are trying to have metadata every day about the data usage that we have. Too much complicated. In terms of what? We will tell you to have this metadata, how much carbon footprint it's consumed to have this information every day, how much cost, and how long it takes to have this metadata, okay?
Yeah, and for that, we will have several solutions. Why solution? Because when you use a cloud provider, Google Cloud or others, you have many times a different way to do the same thing. You can use raw services like VMs and build what you want on top of VMs, or manage your serverless services with less customization, but more flexible and more managed way to do the things. I will present you three different ways, and the first one is the old good way, is the VM. What we do in our VM is to, in sequence, request all the projects on our organization. For all the projects, we request all the data sets. For all the data sets, we request all the tables and get the metadata on the tables, number of rows, volumes, and so on. And we do that in sequence. And it takes a time, but it finishes, I think.
So imagine you do table by table, data set by data set. A company like mine and the one from Guillaume has a lot of tables, and I'm sure you already know, because it's big. It takes 24 hours. So OK, not that bad, but imagine if tomorrow we have more data. Remember what I say as an introduction. I need this data at least one times per day. So if it takes 26 hours, I have a problem. So that's my first problem. The second problem, I don't know if it's the case or not, it's the cost. I don't know how much money do you have, but okay, I see it costs more than $4,000 per month. Per month meaning one run per day. So it's one run per day additionally at the end of the month, that's the price. Huh? It's not the price of one run, of course. And in terms of CO2, we have a number. Okay, approximately 200 kilograms of CO2. We don't know if it's good or bad, but do we have another solution?
Yeah, we use another solution and a more modern solution. We use a solution based on containers. And we use managed services. We use App Engine Flex to deploy a custom containers on App Engine Flex. What's App Engine Flex? It's a managed solution or PaaS, platform as a service. And in my definition, is a service that you have nothing to configure. You take your container, you deploy your container, and magically it's run. It's auto-scale according to the traffic on your container. It scales up and down. And it keeps always one instance warm, at least, to be sure to be ready to process the new request incoming. With App Engine, we designed this architecture with a cloud scheduler that trigger an endpoint on App Engine that create a lot of tasks in Cloud Task, and then in parallel, you have other endpoints to on the same App Engine services to request the metadata on BigQuery. The task, for example, is request this project, this dataset, and this table, and you do that in parallel. And the result is quite different.
So the result, in terms of time, we see not so big difference. So not very great. In terms of money, first great news. OK, I can save a lot of money for myself to doing something else. In terms of CO2, again, it's very, very different because you compare two different kinds of architecture and different generation of solution. But can we do something better, Guillaume?
Yeah, we can do something better because App Engine Flex is quite old. It has been released, I think, 10 years ago. Quite old, and we have modern services. It's named CloudRun. CloudRun is a serverless product. So the difference, again, for me in my definition, that's again like managed services, you have nothing to configure easily. You can take your container and deploy it. It scales automatically from zero to hundreds, thousands of instances, and especially because you can scale to zero, you pay only for what you use. If you don't use it, you don't have instances and you don't pay for it. If you start to use it, of course, you start to pay. And one of the most popular services for running containers on Google Cloud is CloudRun. CloudRun is container-based, so container also is very popular because it's a modern way to package any application, any binaries. It scales automatically, of course, as I said. It also manages concurrent requests. If you have a look to Cloud Function, for example, with Cloud Function, you can, Cloud Function first generation, you can process only one request on one instance. So if you have 10 requests, you have 10 instances, and it's not very efficient. With CloudRun, you can have a concurrent processing on the same instance. You have 10 requests processed in the same time. And the most interesting feature for me is the Knative compliance. In fact, CloudRun implements Knative APIs. That means if you install Knative on top of any other Kubernetes cluster, on GKE, on-prem, on other cloud providers, you can deploy the exact same container on CloudRun and on Knative. That's wonderful for the portability. I would like to perform a focus about the concurrency and the billing. Why? Because, in fact, here you can see that you start to pay, it's the blue part, when the first request comes in and when the latest request has been processed. That's the blue part. You can process several requests in the same time. And the gray part, in fact, the instance is up and running, but no requests are processed, and you don't pay for that. Maybe Google Pay, but not you. And that's why it's very important and very efficient in terms of cost and processing. A last word about the architecture, the exact same as App Engine Flex. Why? Because you use the exact same container, but deploy on other platform. Again, a cloud scheduler, a first endpoint to create a lot of tasks, and then to have a parallel processing of the task on CloudRun again. And the result is different.
So the number, you can see we increase a lot the time elapsed to do the job. So that's a good news because remember what I say, normally, we will have more and more data on this data warehouse today, next month, next year. So it's good to see that scalability for the future will be okay. We also decreased the money we spend, so another great news for you, but also for me. And also in terms of CO2, okay, 25% less. It is very great. So let me give you an overview of the two results, but before that, I just want to say, where are these results coming from, very quickly? First is the CO2. CO2 is coming from the carbon footprint dashboard of the cloud console that you all already have access to. We do an export on BigQuery every day, and we use the data. Billing also comes from the billing export that is natively available and exposed into BigQuery on a table on a daily basis. And the time elapsed is measured basically on cloud monitoring, looking at the logs, beginning, end of the job. And we do the report for you to be there with you today. So we have the three evaluations. You can see difference. But Guillaume, I am a little bit interested to know why, between some recent architecture, we have this difference. Can you explain me the difference between the PaaS and the serverless?
Yes, because it's strange because you use the same container, the same architecture, and we don't have the same result in terms of performance, in terms of CO2, in terms of cost. In fact, as I said, when you use solutions on the cloud, you have different ways, and according to the service and the solutions that we implement, you have different behavior at the end. In fact, with App Engine Flex, you have two things. The first one, App Engine Flex never scales to zero. That means you have at least one instance up and running. That's why the green line never scale to zero. Then, when you have a parallel processing of many tasks, the problem is the following. With App Engine Flex, the scalability is not based on the number of requests, it's based on the CPU usage. And when you query an API like BigQuery to get the metadata, what you do? You wait. You perform an API call and you wait for an answer. And of course, if you wait, you don't use CPU time and you don't scale so much. The difference with Cloud Run, so you scale to zero, but the autoscaler is based on the number of requests that you have. And because you have a lot of requests in parallel, you can scale very fast from zero instance to more than 700 instances during two hours per day. And that's the difference of cost and speed. But that's not the only one difference between serverless and older architecture or legacy or standard architecture. And I'm sure, Antoine, you have one bonus for us.
A little bonus, which is not a technical one, but very important for you also. The choice that you will make, and it's basically the conclusion of this presentation, is very important in terms of what we call the shared responsibility model. Because if you prefer to do some infrastructure more than some serverless, it is not a problem. We are not saying this is bad. We are just saying, keep in mind that you have something to do that is different than if you select serverless in terms of contract of responsibility between you and the cloud provider. Okay, if I have the VM, if I prefer having the possibility to customize something, but I also have the mission to update the VM, where if I use Cloud Run, it is not my job to do that. I let that to Google. So it's very important to keep that in mind. But do we have a last bonus, Guillaume?
Yes. Also a bonus in terms of high availability. Why? Because if you have to have a matrix every day, you have to be sure that your process runs every day. And if not, you have an issue in your following of the matrix. That's why you want to be high available, at least at regional scale, where you run your app. And if you have a VM, in our example, in fact, you need to have an architecture that makes you resilient in case of issues of your VM. So if you deploy something in one region, we deploy one VM. But if the VM goes down, you need to have other VM up and running to continue your processing. But you don't need two VM. In fact, you need three VM. Why? You have to face this pattern. You have one instance goes down, the other one is in maintenance, and the third one is ready to serve your traffic. That's why you need at least three VM in one zone to be high available in one zone. Now, if you want to be high available at regional scale, you need to repeat this pattern for all the zones of your region. So at least 3 VMs for 3 zones, 9 VMs at the end. When you have a look to serverless, it's not the same. If you have the habit to deploy services on serverless, in fact, you never mention the zone, only the region, in fact. You deploy Cloud Run, App Engine, or Cloud Function on a region. Why? Because natively, it's not deployed on one zone, but in all the zones of the region. So by default and out of the box, serverless products are natively high available at regional scale. And remember, you pay for what you use. Remember also the difference in terms of cost and carbon footprint for serverless with Cloud Run and with one VM. Here, 9 VMs. For me, the serverless is really the future to save money, to save the planet, and also to save time, to go faster, to deliver values. So thank you very much. Thank you for your time. If you want to have some questions on Twitter, LinkedIn, or so on, don't hesitate to reach us, Antoine and I. And thank you very much for your attention, and enjoy your rest of your day.
Thank you.